Hi everyone, I'm Mathura and I'm a Processing 2018 fellow. And today in this video, we're going to be talking about the ongoing accessibility work in the p5 web editor. Just to give you a bit of background about this project, it was started by Claire Kearney-Volpe in 2016 as part of her Processing Fellowship as a way to make coding accessible to people with low vision and blindness. It was started in collaboration with Chancey Fleet, who works over at the NYPL Braille and Talking Book Library. And they've been in consultation with field experts such as Sina, Bahram, Josh, Miele, and Austin, Seraphin, to all of whom we'd like to give a huge shout out. The project started off as making the p5 web editor accessible, but has now extended to making p5.js accessible both inside and outside the editor. Today, we're going to be specifically talking about the features within the web editor that make it more accessible. Before we start, let me just introduce the concept of a screen reader to those who aren't familiar. The screen reader is a tool that reads out the contents that are present in your screen along with events such as button clicks and also mentions headings, etc. Today I'm going to be running the JAWS screen reader on a Windows machine and on the Chrome browser. The p5 web editor also has good support on the NVDA screen reader on the Firefox browser. Support on the macOS is not as good yet, and that's something that we're working on. So let's take a look at the accessibility settings. If you go to the Preferences tab, or the Preferences button in the p5 web editor, you'll notice that there are three tabs under it, or three types of settings under it. One of them is General, one is Sketch, and one is Accessibility. So we're going to head over to the Accessibility settings now.
Exit Preferences button. General Settings tab, select the Use JAWS Key. Sketch Settings tab, Use JAWS Key plus Alt plus M to move Accessibility
okay.
tab, Use JAWS
so
Key
So we're now on the Accessibility tab. So I'm going to select that right
Space.
Now.
Accessibility tab, Use JAWS Key plus Alt plus M to move the controlled element.
Okay, so under Accessibility, we're going to find out what features are available. So the first one is?
Blank. Heading level 4 lint warning sound.
So lint warning sound. This feature will ensure that your program beeps when there's a mistake in your code. We're now going to go over to preview sound, which is an option under this, to familiarize ourselves with what that sounds like. So first we're going to go
lint warning on radio button not checked, 1 of 2.
And turn on the lint warning sounds.
Space, settings main region on. Lint warning off radio button not checked, 2 of 2. Off. Preview sound button.
Okay.
Space, preview sound button, space.
So it's that little ding that you hear, that's the sound you'll hear if there's an issue with the code.
Blank. Heading level 4.
The next feature is the accessibility text space canvas. What this does is this feature ensures that there is either a text or a sound equivalent of the visual output that there is on the canvas. There are three types of accessible outputs that are available. The first one is the plain text output. This basically describes the visual content present on the canvas. There's first a general description of the elements on the canvas, such as, let's say we draw a red ellipse, then the summary will let us know that there is a say, gray canvas of size 400 by 400 with one element. And then we can go down and get a little bit more detail, saying that one element is an ellipse. And then we can go further down to get more details about these shapes, such as its position and the area it covers, etc. The second kind of output is the table text output. What this essentially does, it lays out the contents of the canvas in form of a table based on the spatial location of the element. A brief description of the canvas is available, followed by the actual table. And then once again here, if you go further down, you'll get detailed descriptions of each element. And the last output is the sound output. What this does, it explains the movement of objects present in the canvas. Top to down is represented by a decrease in frequency and left to right through panning. If you're going to be using sound output, it's just essential that you're wearing stereo headphones. Right now, I'm going to turn all of these outputs on.
Heading left text output on checkbox not checked.
Oh,
space, text output on check, plain dash table output on checkbox not checked. Space, table out, table dash sound output on checkbox not checked. Space, sound
okay.
output on checkbox checked.
So now that we have turned on all the accessibility features,
table
I'm just going
text.
To go back up and exit preferences.
Table out, plain text up, heading, heading, blank, brief off, lint on, lint, heading, blank, accessible sketch set, general settings tab, use exit preferences button.
Okay.
Space, expand file navigation button.
So now that we've closed all the preferences, let's actually start coding. So to be able to demo the outputs, I'm going to be drawing a simple ellipse on the screen. So let's go to the coding region.
Console main region, wrapping to top, main dash navigation, navigation, recode editor main region.
Okay, so I'm the code
expand
editor region.
Navigate sketch dot. Create canvas left right brace, line 3.
So now we're in the code editor region and you can see that it's reading out the code, right? So
function setup left paren right paren left brace, line 1.
So at the end of each line, it also says the line number that it is in. So I want to go down to the draw function, to the end of the draw function and add an ellipse over there.
Right brace. Background left function draw left paren right paren left brace, line 5.
So now this is in function draw.
Background left paren 220 right paren semicolon, line 6.
Okay, so this is where the background's being drawn.
R-O-U-N-D left 2,
it's going to go to the end of this line.
Blank. Enter, line 7.
And in the next line, I'm going to draw an ellipse. Let's draw an ellipse of, let's say, a width and height of 50 with their center at 100, 100. The x at 100 and the y at 100.
E-L-L-I-P-E. Left paren 100, comma 100, comma 50, comma 50. Right semicolon.
You might have heard the linting sound now, but we'll get back to that in a bit. So I've added the code to draw an ellipse.
Draw left paren. Right, right.
So
function
let's go back to the main navigation region.
Console main region. Wrapping to top. Main dash navigation navigation region. Project dash menu file edit sketch help and list end. User dash link login or link sign up list end. Main dash navigation navigation reach blank. Play sketch button.
Okay. So now here in the main navigation region, we'll notice that there is a play sketch button followed by
play only visual sketch button.
A play only visual sketch button. So the main difference between these two is that if you have not turned on the accessibility features or the accessible outputs in the preferences as we did, if you press play sketch, then it will automatically turn on the accessible outputs for you, only text. But instead, if you turn on the accessible outputs as we did, then it doesn't matter which one of the two you choose. You could either press play sketch or play only visual sketch and it will give you the same result. So I'm going to go ahead and say play sketch.
Stop sketch button, play only visual sketch, play sketch button, space, play sketch button.
Okay, now if we go through the regions available on the web page, we'll notice that there's one additional region, which is the output region.
Code editor main region. Console main region. Sketch output main region.
There we go. So let's go down the sketch output main region and let's hear what the results are.
Heading level 1 text output.
Okay, so that we're in text output now.
Text output summary main region. Your output is a 400 by 400 gray left paren 220, 220, 220 right paren canvas containing the following one object colon. List of one items. Bullet same page link white ellipse.
So it tells us that one item is a white ellipse, and if we go further down, we'll get more details on the ellipse.
At top left covering 1.23% of the canvas.
There we go.
List end. Text output summary main region end. White ellipse location equals top left coordinates equals 100x 100y area equals 1.23%. Blank. Heading level 1 table output.
So that was all the information present in the plain text output, and now we're going into table output. We'll just quickly see the summary here and then change the code to hear the sound output.
Table gray left paren 220, 220, 220 right paren canvas is 400 by 400 of area 160000 contains one object dash one ellipse. Table text output summary main region end.
And now
same
after this
link white ellipse.
Yeah, and after the summary it goes to the table output. One thing to note is all the elements that are present in within the table are links so that it's easy to jump between them. Now let's go back to the code and make this ellipse move across the screen so that we can hear what the sound output will be like. So I'm going to exit and go back, exit this region and go back to the code editor region.
Elements main region. Wrapping the top main dash navigation navigation. Code editor main region. Expand. Sketch.js. Create canvas left parent 400. Right brace.
Okay, so what we can do now is make the ellipse move from left to right, and how we're going to do this is by let's create a variable on line one above function setup.
Sketch.js. L. E.
So I'm going to create a variable x that's whose value is 0, and within draw
right brace.
I'm going to make the value of x increase by 1 each time.
Space left length.
So that would be x equals x plus 1. And within the ellipse function.
100,150 right parent semicolon line 9.
Right. So within the ellipse function, we have 100 comma 100 comma 50 comma 50. I'm going to change the first one to be
zero,
x
comma 0 1.
Just one thing to know, if you're coding with the screen reader on, just make sure to have high verbosity settings turned on your screen reader so that you can hear all the punctuations, because that's very important to the syntax of your code. Okay, so now we've made this code. Let's hear it again.
Ellipse left parent x 150 50 right parent semicolon line
okay.
9.
So it's x comma 100 comma 50 comma 50. Awesome. Now let's play this code again. So I'm going to exit the editor.
Line let x equals sketch.js.
And I'm going to
console
go to
main read sketch output main heading level 1 text output.
Another shortcut to play your code automatically is to press Control Enter if you're on Windows, or Command Enter if you're on a Mac. I'm just going through so that we familiarize ourselves with the layout of the elements.
Table output elements main read. Wrap in the top main dash navigation code editor main region. Visit auto dash stop sketch button. Play only visual sketch button. Play sketch button. Space. Play sketch button.
The computer's a little overworked, so it sounds a little sad when it's making these sounds. But what's actually happening is, let's stop this sketch real quick.
P5.js web editor vertical bar.
What's happening is because the ellipse was moving from left to right, if you were wearing stereo headphones, you would have heard the sound move from your left headphone to your right, left earphone to your right earphone. Now let's make the ellipse move top to down and see what happens.
Code editor main read console main region length. Code editor make current line like code editor make current line 1 blank list end. There are no link messages.
Sorry, let's go back to code editor region.
Code editor main region. Expand sketch dot function setup.
So I'm going to go to the line where we're drawing the ellipse.
Function draw x equals x background left pair ellipse left parent x 150 50 right parent semicolon line 9.
So instead of making it x comma 100 as the x and the y, we're going to make it the x value 100, the y value x, and we're going to delete. So let's hear this line again.
Left parent 100, x 50, 50 right parent semicolon, line 9.
Okay, so now let's go ahead and play this code.
Function let x Sketch.jk console main wrapping to top main dash navigate project file edit sketch help and list end user link login or links list end main dash navigation blank play sketch button.
Okay.
Space play sketch button.
And we can hear now that the frequency is reducing. I'm going to stop the sketch real quick. So we can hear that the frequency is reducing. Now when you... Now let's say you have an object moving diagonally from top left to bottom right. You'll hear the frequency reduce and simultaneously you'll hear the sound moving from the left to your right earphone. So that's a way to tell that it's diagonal movement. And finally, let's look at linting. So let's go back to our code and make an error.
Code editor main region expand sketch. Function setup left paren right paren left brace line 2. Create canvas left paren 400 right paren 0 comp space 4 0.
So this line has create canvas left paren 400 comma 400 right paren semicolon. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the last two elements. I'm going to remove the semicolon and the right parenthesis.
Semi right paren.
And you hear the ting now. So if we go to the end of the code region.
Fun exit back ellipse right console main region.
And go to the console region just above the console
blank.
Region.
Code editor main region end. Current line 1.
You'll hear the current line of where your screen
blank.
Is.
List end. Error in line 2 colon unmatched of
and you'll find a list
race.
That has the errors that have been recognized because of the mistake in the code now.
Warning in line 4 colon expected apostrophe right paren apostrophe and instead saw apostrophe right brace.
So
lint messages list of 3 items.
Right. So those were the 3
warning
items.
In line
and
4 colon expected apostrophe
just playing
right
through them
paren
again.
Apostrophe and instead saw apostrophe right brace. Error in line 2 colon unmatched apostrophe left brace. Error in line 10 colon unrecoverable syntax error. Left paren 100% scanned right paren.
Okay, so when it gives you the lint warning, it gives you, is it a warning? Is it an error? It gives you the line number and it gives you the issue. With this, it's possible to find out what the issue is and where it is. If you hear that again, you'll see that it's saying that there is a missing semicolon and parenthesis, and that's why this issue is happening. So these two used in combination is the summary of all the features that are available in the accessible settings. Feature that we'd like to talk about is the high contrast mode. For users with low vision, we have a theme that is high contrast. You can find this under preferences under the first tab, under general settings under theme. I'm going to show that as well right now very quickly. So let's go to
console main region, wrapping to top, code editor main region, preferences button.
Okay. So I've gone to the preferences.
Space, preferences, settings, main heading, level 2
and
settings.
And let's go to general settings.
Unlabeled, general settings, tab selected, use JAWS, sketch settings, access blank. Heading level 4 theme.
Yeah, and under general settings, you'll find theme. And there are 3 themes, light, dark, and high contrast.
Light theme on ray light. Dark theme on radio button not checked, dark. High contrast theme on radio but space p5.js web editor dark light theme.
So I've done on the high contrast mode, I'm just going to exit this.
One button, space, expand file navigation button.
So this is the high contrast mode. It makes it easier to use the editor and also to present sometimes. So yes, that's a wrap. That's all the features. As we mentioned, this is an ongoing project. If you or someone you know is using any of these features, we'd love feedback and we're constantly working on improving these. Thank you so much.